Hey friends, how are you guys doing today? I hope you're doing so, so well, and welcome back to another video. Today we're gonna talk about the things that sold for me in the month of September 2024. So we're gonna take a look back. I'm gonna tell you guys exactly how much I actually sold. The numbers will be broken down, and I'm also going to go through some of my best sales of the month. I'm going to just show you guys sales $50 and above. So I have tons of sales that are under that, but I feel like the $50 and above sales are really good brands, really good pieces for you guys to know more about. So I'll have a video going of the listings that have sold on the screen so you guys can see my pictures, but also what I write in those listings that actually help them to get sold. And so I think it's going to be super fun. I know that I love watching what sold videos. It does help me know what to pick up when I'm out thrifting, especially if I'm wanting to resell those pieces online for a profit. And so today is the day. I have things that sold on Mercari, eBay, and Poshmark today, and we're gonna break it all down for you. So if that sounds good to you, then make sure you hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any videos that I post. Now, let's jump into the $50 sales, and we'll make our way up to the number one sold for a lot of money. My number one and number two sales both sold for over $100. So we'll get there in a second, but let's start a little bit lower and give you guys some more attainable, just kind of $50 sales that could really help build the building blocks of your business up. Okay, let's do it. So this first thing that sold, it sold on eBay. It was this Anthropologie Mackenzie ribbed long duster cardigan in gray. It was a one size fits all piece. I bought it at my local Goodwill, I believe for I got this in the bins for $2. This sold for $49 on eBay, giving us a profit of $40.30. Really love selling Anthropologie. It's one of my best bread and butter brands. And by bread and butter, if you don't know what that means, it just means the things that I sell every day that help build my business. It's not something I only find once in a while. Anthropologie is something that I find a lot. I love to sell it, and it does build up my business. The next thing that sold for $50 was this orange tab pair of vintage Levi Strauss denim jeans. This is the second time I've sold these. The first time I put down the wrong size, so they got sent back to me, but I relisted them at the correct size and they sold for $50 on Poshmark. And so we made $40 from that sale. Next up, another Poshmark sale is this Smart Wool 100% Merino Wool 250 base layers, a quarter zip men's sweater in size extra large. This sold for $50. We made $40 again. And you'll see that I have a lot of sales right at this $50 mark because I list a lot of things at $50. Everybody has their own pricing schemes. On eBay, the things will go up for $49.99. On Poshmark and Mercari, $50. And then I usually list at $35 or $50. I don't normally list anywhere in between there. I don't know why. It just makes sense in my head. I'm sure we all have our own pricing strategies, so feel free to share yours down below. But this sold for $50 on Poshmark. From $50, we make $40, which is good. And I bought that for, I believe, $4.99 at my local Goodwill. I've been finding more smart wool lately, and it makes me so happy because some of those smart wool pieces can go for a really good amount of money. And when I'm looking through racks, when I'm looking, digging in the bins, I'm always feeling for quality. I'm feeling for wool. I'm feeling for silk and linen and really nice pieces because those really, the content of the fabric really does help sell your pieces. And I even made a video on the subject basically of how to tell if clothing is expensive or worth reselling without having to look it up. If you have not watched that, that is a great video. But all that to say that that was a wool piece and it was easy to find the quality because it felt really nice. It felt like wool to me. Next up is a Rails piece. So this was sold on Revolve. It was this Kendra kind of button down with this like very fall print going on. We have a plaid, we have that kind of like lumberjack look. It's very cute. And it was another $50 sale on Poshmark. So from $50, we make $40. This I also got at a Goodwill in my local area, somewhere here in Indianapolis area. And so when we have $5 into it, we get at least $35 net profit, which is awesome on that piece. And this is something that I know, I do a lot of hauls, but I don't often talk about how I keep my cost of goods low. But I just happen to be in a really great space and I don't like paying up for items. And so I often will leave things behind if I have to pay up too much. I like to make a good amount of profit on each piece, but there's so many different ways to do your business and there's no right way to do it. So do whatever works for you. This next piece is an example of something I spent a lot of money on and it sat for a long time. And some of these pieces, like that smart wool piece, I found at the Goodwill, it sold within like 2 weeks. This is a pair of new tags, new in box, Vince Blair quilted slip-on shoes from They're in a size 9. I bought these from Nordstrom Rack when they were having a sale. This was my last pair left. I believe I paid, I don't even know, something like, I don't know, 15, 20 bucks, something ridiculous for these. Thought they would sell fast. They didn't. They sold for $50 and then we made $40. But because I have a lot more into my cost of goods, I don't have nearly as much profit from this pair of shoes. So I feel like for me, just retail arbitrage, I don't love it. It just doesn't work as well for me. Not to say it doesn't work for you, but I feel like I would much rather pay less and wait a while and then not have that money tied up than to have paid so much and also wait a while. Does that make sense? I hope so. Now, before we get into the next piece, I do want to thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Vendoo. I've been working with Vendoo for months, maybe years now. I really love working with them and they're such a support to me and my business. I actually was just in a call with them the other day and we were talking about all the different marketplaces that they are listing to now that you can list to 11 different marketplaces. And they're also always adding things. Like you can list onto Vestiaire now and Grailed and Kitizen and Facebook Marketplace and all of these things. And Vendoo helps you list so effectively, so efficiently. So I'm already doing the listing I would have done already to list to one marketplace. And now with just a few clicks of a button, I list to a second marketplace, a third marketplace, a fourth marketplace. And it's actually been encouraging me to start more accounts on different selling platforms and to diversify my income streams. And so it's been really helpful to me. I really think that you would also benefit from it. It also helps to detect when something sells on one of your platforms and it will automatically take it down from other platforms. So incredibly useful. And it's very affordable in my opinion, especially because if you sell one item on a platform you weren't listening to before, it literally just paid for itself. I cannot say enough good things about Vendoo. But if you guys want to give them a try, you can try them out for free. And then you also can get 25% off your first month if you use my link down in the description. So please give them a try. Just at least try it for free. I don't think you'll regret it. It's been so amazing in my own business. And I think it would really help you as well. So now let's jump back into what has been selling for me. The next item here is a New With Tags dress. It's from 7 for All Mankind. It's a green corduroy shirt dress. It's a women's size medium. This was from an estate sale back when I lived in Maryland. We were selling our house. We stopped in an estate sale. Fun times. I love remembering exactly where I found things. Maybe it's a little bit too in the details for you, but for me, it's like so fun to walk down memory lane and be like, oh yeah, I remember where I got that. So this sold for $50. We made $40. And I believe I paid $5 for that. Now, this is something I was scared to list for a while because I didn't know how to list it, but this was a vintage handmade drindle, a Gunny Sax inspired Oktoberfest dress in size small. This was so interesting, but I loved the look of it. Like, I feel like it could do really well. And so I picked it up in the bins, I believe, for like, I don't know, a dollar or two. It sold for $50. And then we made $40. I had to give measurements, but it was a very interesting piece. I felt like it just kind of had that Gunny Sax vibe that's really popular and really expensive. So I decided to grab her, and I'm glad I did. Next up, the last $50 sale is a Mercari sale. Woo! We are so thankful for a Mercari sale. When you have no selling fees on there, it makes life so nice. So this was a pair of Fate Amano Italian made tooled leather brown boots in men's size 10.5. So these were a nice little like tooled leather men's boot. I found these in the bins. A friend of mine actually handed them to me and said I could have them if I wanted them. And I was like, okay, I'll try it. Why not? Wasn't expecting them to sell very quickly. And they sold within a day or two for $50. So I was like, okay, that's a happy surprise. From $50, we made $50. That's why we love Mercari right now. And Depop has also introduced no seller fees. So let me know how you guys feel about that. I feel like it's been going well for me. I would love to make more sales on Mercari. I'm trying to encourage them over there. So let me know if you guys have any tips for increasing your Mercari sales. Maybe I'll have to make a video about that, do some research. Next up, another Poshmark sale. This was Revolve House of Harlow 1960 Marnie sweater long sleeve dress. Women's size medium. I got this at my local Goodwill. It sold for $55 and we made $41.98. That cost me $7.99 to pick up. And I'm always excited to find Revolve pieces. Revolve does really well for me. House of Harlow 1960, I don't find often. So when I did find this, I thought it would do pretty well, especially with us heading into fall and winter. I feel like the longer I stay in the reselling business, the more I feel like things sell within their season. Or maybe it's just because a lot of my buyers live in the same part of the country as I do, but I just felt like the sweater dress was gonna go right around this time as we head into October. Crazy that we're in October. But yeah, it worked out. It was great. Another $55 sale is this Free People Ottoman slouchy chunky tunic sweater in nutmeg. It was a size large. This came from my own personal closet. I had bought this for myself off of Poshmark. I feel like I got a really good deal, like 20 bucks or something crazy on this sweater. And then I resold it for $55 and made $41.98. So I made money on it, even though it still came from my personal wardrobe and I paid more money than I would at a thrift store for it. But sometimes you just need to sell the clothes that are in your closet. I know I'm about to go through that a lot because I just did a closet declutter and I have so many clothes that I need to now picture and list, unfortunately, but we'll get there. I will do it. So that one was a good sale. And also some specific pieces from Free People just do really well. Like the Ottoman sweater is in high demand, the Easy Street sweater, the Camden sweatshirt. There's just like so many like special things from Free People that people are like looking for in multiple colors, kind of like Lululemon. Like I'm wearing a scuba right now and people will collect them in different colors. I do it too. Next up, this piece was only listed for I think a few days before it sold. It's this vintage Talbots equestrian fox hunt brown wool maxi wrap skirt in a women's size 10. It sold for $55 and we made $44 off of it. I've had this piece for a while. My mother-in-law bought it for me while she was like on a trip in Florida. She FaceTimed me and then it's just been sitting and then I finally pictured it and listed it and it sold like that. So I'm like, oh, well, $55 was just lying around my house and I totally forgot I had that piece. But that's another reminder. You might have something in your duff pile right now that is worth so much money and you just need to get on it and start listing it. Even though I know it's super hard, I've been there too. So there's grace here for sure. Next up, this pair of Sorel Daisy lace-up brown and black heeled leather waterproof booties. Got these at a garage sale. They sold for $59. From $59, we make $47.20. And I believe I paid $10 for these. I knew at the time that they were totally worth it. Anything that's from Sorel that's like a unique looking shoe, I am very, very happy to pick up. Sorel booties just sell so well for me. I have sold so much Sorel and I always sell it for, I feel like around $50, a lot of times more than that. It really just depends on the piece you're picking up. I will leave behind the very plain pieces nowadays, especially like a kid's Sorel. I'm not wasting my time as much or money on those, but a pair of leather like heeled boots, those were awesome. Next up, Bogley Oli slim fit jeans and white denim size 32. These sold for $60, but I also had these for, I feel like, 3 years. They were around for a long time. I'm currently in the middle of doing a liquidation on some of my inventory, and I feel like if I would have made it to the bin where this pair of jeans was, I probably would have gotten rid of them. So I'm glad that they sold before I did that. These sold for $60. We made $48. And I got these in the bins, but I got these in like Columbus, Ohio, like in a random trip across the country. I just stopped at the bins. And I believe I paid like, what, a dollar or two for those. Made $46 probably at the end of the day. Awesome. Next up, we have a Zadig and Voltaire sale. This is the Real Satin Dress in Bleu de Gris. Women's size small. I got this at a buy-sell trade store. I believe I paid $12 for this and it sold for $60. So from $60, we make $48, but we make about $36 net profit, which is pretty good. Next up, Donald J. Pliner Zelda black knee-high sock boots in a 9.5. These were so cute. I really thought these were adorable. If I actually could wear them somewhere, had a place to wear them, I feel like I could have kept them. But they did sell for $60. But I was looking at the pictures that I took of these boots, and I could tell from the rug where I'm taking the pictures that these were pictured while I still lived in Maryland, which I have been living in our house here in Indianapolis, for well over a year now. So those were sitting for a hot minute. Eventually they sold for $60 and we made $48. But for the life of me, I can't tell you where I got those. Was it the bins? Was it a Second Avenue thrift store? I don't know. It's probably Second Avenue, knowing myself from back then, but eek, those have been around for a while. I need to be a little bit better about lowering prices if something has been sitting. And that's something I am putting on my to-do list for this next month, is to try to look at things that have been sitting and lower their prices. Next up, this was a pretty recent find. If you guys remember, I found this Portland Leather Goods circle crossbody bag. It's a large leather purse in tulip pink. It was in great condition, like literally brand new. Found it in my local Goodwill outlet, the bins, and I paid, I think, a dollar for it, and it sold for $60, and we made $48. So $47 net profit is nothing to sneeze at. Love that for us. That was fun. I'm not a purse expert. I'm definitely more in the clothing sphere. I know more about that, but that was a really cute bag. Next up was this pair of Fry Jane strappy heeled chocolate brown leather riding boots in a size 7.5. Honestly, I'm a little shocked that these sold for less money than another pair of Fry boots we're going to talk about in a second. We'll talk about that though, because it's very interesting to me. These were an amazing pair of like tall, strappy leather shoes. I guess maybe just the harness boots do better in general. These were listed at $100, and then I sent off 40% offers on my closet one of the days here in September, and they sold on that offer. So $60, we make $48 from that sale, and I paid $9 for these, so around $40 net profit, which isn't actually that much profit for how nice of a pair of leather boots these were, but they still did well, and I'll take that. I'll accept that if that gives me, you know, a good amount of money. Next up, another quick sale was this Veronica Beard 100% silk floral Aries top and ruffled details. I picked this up just recently in one of my videos with you guys, and it sold for $62. From $62, we make $49.60. But this also was only listed for a few days before I think I received an offer on it. Either that, or I sent out my automatic offer that gets sent out with Posher VA, and it did really well. Like, it sold really quickly. I bought it for $4.99. Veronica Beard, I love her. Love everything she makes. I think it's gorgeous. Someday I would love to find some more Veronica Beard and maybe Jenny Kane. Oh, those are dreams of mine. But yeah, $62, $49, about $45 of net profit. We love that. Now we have a vintage 100% leather jacket and skirt set that I also picked up from the Goodwill outlet, aka the bins, where you pay per pound and not per item. And so I paid probably a dollar or two for each piece. So maybe $5 into the whole thing. It sold for $65 on Poshmark, and we got $52 of profit. So around $47 of net profit at the end of the day. Awesome sale. That's another thing about just vintage and also leather in general. I'm constantly picking up leather pieces if they smell okay and are in great condition, because leather is one of those fabrics that is just so expensive that even if it doesn't have a brand that will sell it, we'll have that factor of its material going for it. So the next piece was a recent pickup as well. The last time I went to the Goodwill outlet, I found this pair of Fry black leather harness boots. They're genuine leather cowboy boots in a women's size 6.5. These were given to me by somebody that didn't want to get them because they were kind of destroyed on one of the shoes. One of the leather straps on the top of the shaft of the boot was like ripped off. And so I disclosed that in my listing, but this still sold on eBay for good money. I think it's because it's a pair of harness boots, but they sold for $65 on eBay with like some gnawing into them and a strap missing. All of it disclosed. So from $65 on eBay, we made $56.12, and I paid $2 for those. So $54 of net profit on a piece that was not in perfect condition, to me, is a huge win. I was tempted to not even get them because I didn't know if people would buy them. And I was like, you know what? I'm in the bins. If this was like a $20 pair of boots, I probably would have left them. But for $2, I was like, what's the harm in trying? And I'm really happy with that. So maybe I should list some more flawed items with the flaws obviously accurately portrayed, but maybe even flawed items will sell. I usually try to steer away from them, but I don't know, maybe it's worth it. The next two are my best sales of the month, and we go up quite a bit. We've been slowly climbing, but we're gonna go from $65 to a $95 sale. So this next piece sold for $95. It's a Diesel woolen alpaca sweater in a men's size large, extra large, green and black camo distressed. But the Diesel can do really well. I don't know if their jeans are really doing as great unless they're like a more rare style, but this sweater was really cool. It was like really like pulled and looked a little grungy, but it was in amazing condition. Like, it was in perfect shape. It was intentionally made that way. And then it sold for $95. We made $76. I think this sold on Poshmark as well. But I sourced this in a Whatnot show. So I do that sometimes where I'll watch Whatnot shows and bundle things together that I'm going to resell. And I often have some credits to use on Whatnot from selling there, from referring people. And so I found that to be a really good use of those credits, is to buy something that will sell for $100. Like, that's amazing. So that was a really good pickup, and it's actually put Diesel on my radar quite a bit for menswear especially. I don't know if the same shirt would have done as well if it was in women's. And so that was a really nice sale though, but it cannot even compare. The next sale was about double that piece. So we went from $65 to $95. And now we're gonna hit a nice high note at $180. This piece sold within one day. I showed it to you guys. I listed it quickly. It was this New With Tags Alpenrock Kits Fleece Jacket in Heather Midnight Charcoal. It was a size women's 4, and it was brand spanking new. I was shocked to find this at my local Goodwill. I think I paid around $6 for it. And it sold within one day. I think it was originally like $240 or $260 new at Alpenrock. I think that they accepted my initial like 10 or 20% off offer that I sent out automatically. for that $180 amount. So it went like that, $180 from a $6 investment. From Poshmark, we make $140 net profit after that. We made $138 off of that little jacket, which is crazy. But now this brand is definitely on my radar, Alpen Rock. So I'll definitely have the video scrolling here of this listing, but that is a brand that you should definitely be aware of because that was a crazy fast sale. And for such good money, I would happily pick up this brand over and over again. So those were all the sales from the month. Those are just the high ones, I should say. Those were all the high sales from the month. But in total, from Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, we sold $3,740.09 worth of items this month, which I'm pretty happy with. I am aiming for that $4,000 amount. We're getting closer and closer. I do think, though, if I would have even done one Whatnot show this month, I would have been over $4,000. So really, this might be my invitation to myself to get back doing live shows on Whatnot. I do enjoy them. They are a little bit of work on the front end, but they are worth it, at least for the profit that you can make from it. So we're at 3,700 in total sales. And then my net after all the platforms took their fees was $2,931.66. So right around $2,900 is what I actually got paid at the end of the day. And of course, this doesn't include all this that I do on YouTube. It doesn't include partnerships and working with brands. And so I'm really happy with how last month went. It was a little busy, but we made it through and we had really good sales. And now I'm gearing up to try to make October even better. So let me know if you guys had any fun sales. Tell me about them in the comments down below. I would love to read about them. I love sharing it with you. So I'm sure you want to share your sales with other people too. But also thank you again to Vendoo for working with me on today's video. And if you want to give them a try, then make sure you use my link down below to get 25% off your first month when you try them out. But also you can try them out for free. You don't even have to pay them to give it a go. See if it'll help your business. And I feel like it really will do so. So I feel like you'll see the value in it right away. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. And until the next video, bye.